Problem with granola bars is it's gonna be stuck in my teeth for a little while. That's annoying. Oh well. Alright. Let's see. So, I'm trying to get back into Gungeon a little bit. I took a break. Because, let's see. I took a bit of a break from Gungeon. Because, you know, I like this game. But when you do it, when you do like 3-4 hours a night for like a week, A, you lose your mind. B, you end up with so much content bound for YouTube that it's just like, there is no way I can possibly get this all. Like, get this all out and whatnot. And so you end up with just with like such a heavy backlog that it's like, man, what's even the point of playing this game for a while? And that's why, like, this game goes away. That's why Stardew went on a very long hiatus, stream-wise. And I'm actually just about to run out. I need to remember to put up my episodes and stuff. But still. Let's see. But, I don't know. It's fun, though. I like it. I like all games. Yeah, this one. Oops. That one Illuminati was ready for me. Okay. Let's see. Neon Chrome would be good. Yeah, I could do some Neon Chrome tonight. Wouldn't mind doing that. I definitely need more of that than I do of Gungeon. It's just, unlike most roguelikes, Gungeon requires me to be awake. Which kind of messes with my head. Because, you know, trying to play this game while tired hurts. You know, my eyes hurt, my reflexes dull, and eventually I just start dying. Because that's not the kind of game that you can just breeze through. At random. Like, Binding of Isaac, even when I was, like, dirt tired, I could beat that game. I'd say, like, a good 90% of the time, give or take. Because it was such a casual experience. Oh, tried. I always forget that, like, goes around. Yeah, I repeat myself. Yeah, I do that, too. I don't know. It's, like, a whole number of things. Like, Dark Souls, I get worse, but I can still play it. But this game truly just can't, this game I just truly can't play while tired. Which sucks, though, because, like, you know, I'm so overworked right about now that it's just like, well, the only times I can play this are when I'm tired. And then I start recording it off camera, but I don't know, at that point I'd lose interest. Did I ever finish Hyper Light Drifter? No. I really want to, but the game broke for so long that I lost all interest in doing so. So for people that don't know, for Hyper Light Drifter, I ran into a bug where I died and then my screen went black. And they didn't fix it for like a week. In fact, I don't even know if they fixed it properly. I only fixed it because I figured out a alternative strategy here. Table Tech Rage, I will go with that. Snowballer's not bad, but we don't need it. But so yeah, I only fixed it because I figured out like a glitch that would unglitch my glitch. Which is not a good, that's not a good way to do it, but it still took me a week to figure out and fix and whatnot. And it was just so hard for me to want to, come back to it after that, because you get burnt by something. You don't want to deal with, like, technical problems. Like, for example, I've got the Nio, I got the Nio demo downloaded, and I did, like, a 3-hour recording of it. Which I completely lost, and I have zero interest in playing it right now, again and whatnot. Cause I lost a 3-hour recording, and it's just like, this isn't fun anymore. So, explosive decoy. That sounds more useful than, sounds like it'd be more useful than the ammo drop. The ammo drop's nice, but it's temporary. I really wish it just had a really long cooldown. Instead of being single use. Because then I would absolutely, like, love that item. Space Pirates and Zombies 2 would be great when they finally finish it. Oh, hell yeah! I love Space Pirates and Zombies 1. That was, I played the shit out of that until I couldn't anymore because the difficulty scaling on Space Pirates and Zombies 1 was awful. Ha! It killed the bird for me. Oh, they're not damaging it. Since they're not shooting at the decoy wasn't exploding. That was really interesting. I didn't know if it was on a timer or whatnot, but I'm okay with that. Alright, let's keep going. It's a special room. Special room is this guy. We're not going to be able to afford any of these things. Oh, well. Let's keep going down. Unfortunately, there's no, like, waypoints or stuff. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to Space Pirates and Zombies 2. That game... the first game was fun. You know, just the end game was really frustrating. I think it was because, like, you would lose ships and it would cost you, like, an arm and a leg to get back. And it didn't feel like farming just so I could finish the game. Let's see. There are a couple other games that kind of function similarly. But yeah, absolutely love that series. And I've been waiting for Space Pirates and Zombies for, like, months now, and they just have not. Alright, let's go blow open that chest. I'm probably not going to get a, I'm probably not going to get anything else. Do have COD. The only Call of Duty I own is Advanced Warfare, and I played it for all of a couple hours. And then I got bored, because I'm not a first-person shooter type guy. Like, I will play games like Borderlands, where it's cooperative, and have fun with it, but if it's like, a multiplayer competitive thing, I have no interest. It's just not my scene. Like, I've tried competitive shooting. I did Counter-Strike Source for years. But it was just so not my thing. That I don't want to deal with, like, that sort of thing ever. I don't know. I like my games to be kind of casual. And I find the environment around Call of Duty to be particularly... Damn. Well, that didn't work. I find the environment around, like, games like Call of Duty just so not fun that I have, like, zero interest in playing any more of it. I don't like how this guy chases you around the room. I really wish he just kind of patrolled in the center or something. Because you have to get around him, but he's got these, like, dumb moves that make it really hard to get around. I don't know. Let's see. I guess I played the Battlefield games for a while, but after 2142, I kind of lost interest in the Battlefield series. What did I play Unturned? It's free. It's free, but it's not fun. What is this? I haven't seen this one before. Pulse Cannon. Cool. I think there's a key hiding behind that. Yep, there is. Okay, let's go get the HP and stuff. Okay, let's keep going. How much ammo does the pulse cannon have? Not much. I guess I'll leave it alone. Or at least, you know. Not use it too much. It'll probably either be a hard room or a go-to boss killing thing. Because, yeah. If a first-person shooter has, like, a really compelling collaborative, cooperative, whatever, mode... Then I will play it. Then I'll be interested in it. But, like, for example, everybody's, like, super stoked about Battleborn and Overwatch. Those two games. And, like, my friends have been discussing whether or not they're going to be picking it up and you know, if it's worth it and stuff. Let's see. We'll sacrifice the blood altar. This might be a bit of a mistake, but the extra damage is always welcome. Let's see. But, you know, a lot of my friends have specifically been saying, like, you know, which one do we get? Because they're more or less in direct competition, which seems kind of insane to me. And I just have no interest in either. Like, if everybody picks it up, I might be interested. But I never bring myself to play competitive shooters. Because there's just no fun factor in it for me. It's just... cyclical, which, I mean, I guess you could say, like, Gungeon's pretty cyclical, too. I'm kind of floored I didn't get shot there. It's cyclical, but it's, like, cyclical competitive, where, like, you know, your mileage will invariably vary. And not generally always in a good way. I guess you could say very similar things about this game, too. But I know, like, in getting better at this, I will appreciate it, and, you know, nobody's going to be swearing at me or you know, just saying stupid shit. I don't know. Like, I will play competitive games if I'm playing with friends. And, like, have the capacity to play with friends. Like, for example, if my friends want to sit down and do, like, a private CSGO match, I'd be okay with it. Because, you know, it'd be something for me and the guys to do as a group, together. And, like, I guess doing, like, hopping into a public lobby of some shooter or whatever could be enjoyable, too. Interesting, you break his mind. Oh, motherfucker. Oh, there goes my armor. Is he dead? I'm not always ready for him. Let's see, what other, like, competitive games are fun? I mean, honestly, like, anything competitive I show on my channel is kind of the style of competitive game I will play. What about PvP and, like, Dark Souls? Eh, I don't know. I don't enjoy Dark Souls PvP that much, but I think that's just because I enjoy the single player so much more. Not to mention, like, there are so many, like, dumb, cheesy things that people will do. I hate invaders in PvP. Like, if I'm doing multiplayer, I'm okay with the invaders, but when I'm solo, it's just like, ah, you're hiding next to the boss, so you can just kill me. Fuck you. Like, there's no interest factor in that. It's just, you know, this person is being a dillhole just so they can profit off of whatever. And I don't like that. I don't enjoy that. Like, if there was, like, a specific arena mode in Dark Souls where, like, you could have a specific PvP build, I'd be okay with it. But it doesn't work that way, so, I don't know. But yeah, getting my friends together for PvP. Eh. It just sounds like more work than it's worth, and honestly, by the time I'm done playing through an entire campaign on Dark Souls, I pretty much have no interest in playing it again. Let's see, so we get the silencer. Oh, it's a pillow, I forgot about this one. They're not similar. Overwatch is purely multiplayer, Battleborn has a co-op mode where it's only story. I mean, maybe. But the problem is, like, it's very obvious that, like, Battleborn, for example, is very specifically focused on, I mean, let's be honest here. Battleborn is very focused on... Oh, god damn it. Well, that couldn't have gone worse. I'm not entirely sure if sacking of that health is actually worthwhile. Oh, whatever, we've got whole HP and stuff. But, like, any multiplayer shooter that, like, just adds a single-player campaign to appeal there still isn't that worth it. Like, I'm trying to think of good competitive shooters with a substantive single-player. I guess, Destiny, actually. Mileage may vary, but I enjoyed Destiny's PvP an okay amount. It was very poorly balanced, and it sucked that, you know, it wasn't set up so new players could hop right in. But at the same time, I felt like Destiny had a fun PvP mode, but also the main campaign was enjoyable. Grindy and dumb, but still enjoyable. I did not kill him. There we go. What about Army of Two? I've never even heard of Army of Two. Like I said, don't have a whole lot of interest in competitive shooters, so I don't look for them. Okay, so I have two guns. We have a chest. So let's take the silencer in. I don't even know if it's gonna be good here. I don't even know what I'm hitting him with. Okay. Trying to outrange these. Yeah, I didn't know where he was. Really wish there was, like, a better marker for where the boss was along the way here. Yeah, what the hell am I even hitting the boss with? Oh, crap. Don't just stand next to that. I'm really trying to get this HP boost here. Okay. What am I? Oh, I'm reloading. Okay. I can work with reloading. There we go. Okay, perfect. I'm shooting pillows? They don't look like pillows. It feels like I'm a pillow shooting a silencer. Aged Bell, Lacuna. What does that do? Briefly stops time. Kind of like the idea of the decoy better. Let's go with the decoy. Lacuna sounds interesting, but not that useful. Okay. So let's go back. I was really hoping he'd sell me some armor. Oh, this is okay. We're gonna go over here, down to the chest. I've got two armor. Right now, we get the Ring of Chest Friendship. Okay, we don't have enough money for this guy, so I'm just going to ignore it. Okay, yeah, if we had one more armor, we could do things. But I can't. Okay, and I guess I'm just going to use the silencer for this this next section. It seriously doesn't look... I really think I'm using a pillow that shoots silencers. Hard to say. Yeah, what about Ark Survival? I might play the Culling at some point. That seems interesting enough. Yeah, so if I can get through this without taking damage and get one more armor. Yeah, this is a problem. So I got Table Tech Money and Table Tech Rage. I'm going to take damage from something stupid. But I'm more interested in getting the shortcut at this point, so I'm actually going to use and abuse my guns. Even if they're not the greatest. Fuck! Alright, we lost it. Oh, I didn't see that there was an elite there. God, I hate this room. Alright, well, I might still be able to make it work, but I don't think it's going to. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we just have another... I think we just have another shotgun on our hands here, but that's okay. Does a fair amount of damage, I'll give it that. So maybe the shop will be forthcoming. I don't know, we'll figure it out. What? Oh. He blended right in. Well, this is moot. Let's keep playing. Yeah, I was too focused on the, I was too focused on there being a... Okay, that was some awkward rolling for sure. I was too focused on the Illuminati to notice that I was in danger. Okay, there we go. That was a bit rough. I think I'll only do two runs of Gungeon tonight. Ah, crap. Because I'm obviously not tuned for this right now. I think it'd be better with something a little bit more casual. But I think that's, like, decidedly true. Ah. I think that's something that's just decidedly true of me at all times. I am a much more casual player than I am a focused one. Okay. Leave the Gungeons in the nuclear throne to the sleep cycles. I'll be perfectly happy with my Binding of Isaacs and my hello ammo. I'll take it. Could have put it on the silencer, but honestly, I don't like the silencer that much. There we go. I go for the explosive barrel. Almost does more work. Well, that wasn't worth it. There we go. Well, this isn't worthing. Working? I don't even know. Okay, so let's see. Let's go back here, loop around, get to the other one. I don't want to be jumping across pits. For the most part, I'm doing fine, but still. Sleep Cycles is a pretty awesome dude. Yup. I am jealous about his skill with games like these. But then again, he pretty primarily plays games like these. Whereas I play like a whole bunch of things. Really, he was playing golf with friends. Huh. Who is he playing with? Bye. Ah, crap. Did not see him at all. I was just like, alright, we killed them all. No, we didn't. Whatever. Not the end of the world. Ah, he was playing with subs. Gotcha. Oh, right! I forgot that Sleep Cycles actually has a sub button, doesn't he? Well, that didn't work. Yeah, someday when I have a sub button, I might be more proactive about that sort of thing. But right now, do not, and YouTube is definitely my main focus. Probably always will. I don't know, I like Twitch, but the concept of being tied to streaming for X amount of hours a day is a little stressful. I kind of prefer my almost goofy version of do whatever I want, mostly whenever I want. I very obviously stick to a schedule or something like that. But YouTube is just a little bit more forgiving. Wow, twofer. Nice! YouTube's a little bit more forgiving about, like, who and what and when and where and why. Whereas, like, if I start streaming late or if I miss a stream or whatever, that's just, like, people gone. That was actually a lot faster than I was expecting. I don't like this gun. It reloads very slowly. Does a very appreciable amount of damage, but it just does not reload quick. It is rough. Alright, whatever. And we're probably making it to level 4 again. What? I was safe and then I wasn't. I don't know if I can go behind that. You'd think you'd be able to, but not always. Okay. Oh, shit. I thought this was like a one of those where you go through it. Table tech. Oh. Does table tech money flip all of them? I have no idea. I'm about to die. And I'm dead. Damn it. All right, whatever. I guess I'm not making it to level 4 tonight. That's fine. That is fine. That was only a 22-minute run. Yeah, fair enough. Okay, let's just do a quick restart. I wanna try that again. I like the Marine. I just don't like it as much. Well, I don't like anybody else as much as him. I'm just not entirely sure about whatever skills I got tonight. That's okay. Someday I will beat this game. Or just get totally distracted and move on to other things. I don't know. There's an infinite number of roguelikes that are infinitely more beatable than this. As much as I'd like to finish it. I keep thinking back to it. Somebody had left a comment being angry at me for not beating the game yet. It's just like, I mean, I play like 8 games a day. Of course I'm not going to be able to finish something. Ah. Fuck you. And your goddamn shoot from off screen bird thing. Alright, whatever. Michelle wants me to stop swearing so much. It's hard, man. It's hard to get rid of, like, verbal tics and habits. I mean, really, it's hard to get rid of, like, any habit you want. And, you know, it's always one of those where you can say it's, like, a matter of will or thinking about something and, you know, make sure you don't. But it's, like, it's not easy to keep that kind of thing, like, out of your vocabulary and whatnot. I don't know. Doesn't really matter that much. And I was thinking about it, it's like, a number of people will tell me that, like, you have to do this or that or whatever to grow on YouTube, and I don't think that's ever actually been particularly true. Alright, we're fighting this guy again. I guess I should probably kill his advisor. It was a little bit closer than I wanted it to be, but that's okay. I don't like the wind-up gun that much. Damn it, we lost it. Yeah, that's the thing I don't like about this boss. For a dude that's going around in a giant chair, he moves fast. Like, at least the Raven is pretty damn slow. But this guy will, corner you like nothing else. I don't like that about this boss. Like, most bullet hells, you never get cornered. You're always generally in the... In most bullet hells, the boss is always kind of like top center of the map and doesn't move too far. This game, I've noticed the bosses are like way more mobile, which isn't like that big of a problem. But it does make it almost impossible to avoid damage here, especially for a game that like pretty much requires that. It's just like, I'm pretty much required. If I want to beat this game, I have to be able to flawless multiple bosses in a row. And that is not easy. We got the camera. I don't want the camera at all. Let's see. What about that one roguelike? Cave Breakers? The dev patched it like twice, and then he hasn't patched it since. As far as I'm concerned, a game that broken, hitting early access... Like that, yeah, I think I'm just gonna stop after this one. Oh, I wonder if my TV is pushed back. I probably pushed it back, I was wondering. It's felt weird since I can tilt my TV back and forward and stuff. Okay. But yeah, for Cave Breakers, for those of you that didn't see any of it, Cave Blazers, not Cave Breakers, my bad. The game more or less just came out in kind of a broken state. And, like, it's playable. It is totally playable and beater and stuff. Oh, you're talking about Vagante. I'm just waiting on Vagante. I loved Vagante. It's a fun game. It's really, really well done. But you play a game, you play any game for 100x episodes. I think it's like 120 plus, because I had a bunch of multi-part episodes there. You play a game that long, and you just lose all interest in playing it anymore. Like, at this point, if somebody asked me to play, Binding of Isaac, I'd probably say no. Just because I have no interest in playing that game again for at least quite some time. Yeah, I like Vagante, it's a cool game, but I burnt out. And I know there's, like, a whole extra another level at the end now, which is cool. But, it's just hard... What's this? Ruby bracelet. Thrown guns explode. What? Any guns thrown while wearing this bracelet will explode. Oh. That's like super useless. Cause that's if I put it down and whatnot. Like if I do the drop item. It'll blow up, like a grenade or whatever, I think? I mean, we can try it with the wind-up rifle. Oh, that's not what we want to do, it's F. No, that's not it. Okay, I have no idea how to throw a gun then. Yeah, the whole update thing. Yeah, I guess that's a good point. The, like, doing it once in a while when they patch it. The problem is there are so many other games that, like, come out that it's very hard to stick with a game. And, like, keep up with it in such a way that, it's hard to stick with a game and keep with it patching throughout early access. Especially because most games aren't that interesting as they go along. Like, what's a good example? I mean, I liked Roguelands enough in comparison to, like, Magicite and stuff, but ultimately it's, like, kind of a diminishing return on how useful these, like, videos are for me, and how interested I am in, like, seeing it. Because ultimately, like, no matter what with most games, the patches are very minor in comparison to, like, what I would hope out of them. Like, generally, like, a game that gives you, like, a nice big ol' feature. Or two to sink your teeth into. Like, that's a patch worth covering. But the problem is you, like, you put it down long enough, you just totally forget about it. Okay. Like, come on. What the? Oh, it's because I dropped the wind-up gun. I was like, why do I have the camera? Floored that I didn't get shot there. Alright, there he goes. Let's keep going. I'm trying to think of good examples of games that have like really fun patches that always like added new features in kind of like interesting and fresh ways. I guess I'm thinking of Scrap Mechanic, but that's just because I'm still like very much interested in Scrap Mechanic. For a while, Dungeon Souls had really fun patches. Like those were awesome. But I felt like it kind of dropped off after a while. And then they just ruined the game, and it's just like, well, this is all lost reason to be covered. They emailed me recently, and I should probably, like, actually do a video or two on it, but it's just like, oh! You know what? A really good one. A really good game that does early access well, in my opinion, is, or was, I really loved Rampage Knights. Ooh, okay, we can buy Table Tech Blanks. We can buy armor from him. Unfortunately, we don't have any armor right now, and we probably won't have two by the time we're done. We'll see. I'll leave the boss for last, but if I can somehow manage to get three armor at the end of this, we might actually be able to get what we need. That's good. But, shoot. Yeah, Rampage Knights had really good early access, because the game was functionally done, like, a long time ago. You know, fairly early on. And so every time they patched the game, it either added, like, some cool new mechanic, or a bunch of new items that were actually fun to get. I need to get Bird and play that again, because that was fun. Hey. Okay, let's give it a go. I suck at this one. Oh. Well, fuck. At least we get one. I always get at least one, so that's good. And it gives me a key. Well, cost effective, but someday I'll be able to ace that one, maybe. I don't entirely know. But yeah, Rampage Knights was always cool, because it would add, like, a cool new thing that you could find along the way. I appreciated that. That's kind of why I liked Binding of Isaac's approach to the expansion pack. I know everybody got, like, super pissed at Isaac being, like, super dickish with the ARG or whatever. But at the same time, like, I really freaking loved... Actually... Fuck you. There we go. I really loved Binding of Isaac's expansions, because they more or less just made the game better and added content, but, like, it wasn't a cyclical thing. You weren't waiting for it forever. You got a completed game, and then the completed game got expanded. And that always felt good to me. Witch Pistol. Never heard of that one before. I'm trying to think of other games with particularly, like, strong early access cycles that, like, you can kind of keep up with. Because most other ones just get really, really boring after a while. Like, I freaking love Cavern Kings. It's a good game. It's fun to play and whatnot. But the development was just so slow and non-cyclical that it wasn't good to keep up with. We have a lot of guns now. Oh, Table Tech Rage and Table Tech Money was the previous one. That one grazed my behind. Fuck. There we go. course the shotgun would have limited range. What game was it that I always loved the shotguns in? Oh, man. Left 4 Dead always had some of the best shotgun play I think I've ever seen. Actually, any Valve game, I feel like, does shotguns particularly great. They were always fun to work with. Wasn't Castle Crashers Early Access? Nope! In fact, Early Access didn't exist. Well, Castle Crashers was a thing. They added some features, but, It was an Xbox Live indie game, but not Early Access. That game came out complete. But yeah, they had never... Early Access didn't even really exist until Minecraft was a thing. Like, most people had never even considered that sort of thing. There were, like, betas and stuff. But the concept of, like, going years, and, like, more or less giving people public access to your dev copy, in that manner, that was completely unheard of. Pretty much for everybody. Up until... I'm going to say it was, like, Minecraft popularized it. I don't know what the first Steam Early Access game was. I'd have to think about that one. Anyway, so we get the poison vial. So let's see, what things can I recover? I guess we might as well do this one. And refill this. Any idea what's going on at E3 this year? I actually don't pay attention to E3. AAA games in general are kind of outside of my speciality, so I just... have generally no interest in what goes on at them. I know EA has a bunch of things. I know there's like Gears of War and stuff, but I might play the new Mirror's Edge. Maybe. If I'm feeling like really motivated to play it. Well, let's hope the Witch Pistol's good. What? 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 Fuck? I've never... What the dicks is up with that fairy? Why did that show up in a boss chamber? Is that the witch pistol that did that? Or is that just, like, complete RNG? I have no idea. And now I'm getting shot a bunch. I mean, go figure, but I just did not expect a sudden extraneous entity to show up in my boss fight. Oh, we are doomed. Yeah. I don't think I'm beating Gungeon tonight. Obviously. I don't think I'm even going to do well in Gungeon. Yeah, what was that? Why was that a thing? Castle Story was the first on Early Access. No. Castle Story was not the first Early Access game on Steam. It was one of the first. It was the first main disappointment, but it was not the first. And I'm dead. Yeah, well, whatever. Which pistol has a chance to transmogrify enemies on hit? Huh. Well, it wasn't really useful there, but I didn't really have many other options. I guess the wind-up gun, maybe? But still. But yeah, why did that fairy show up then and there? That was garbage. Alright, whatever. I'm too tired for this game anyway. So let's switch to something a little bit easier.